What's up YouTube? Welcome to Team Seto. Today, I bring you the fourth chapter of the story of the War Chalice. If you have not seen the previous chapters, I will be leaving the link in the description below. Well, without further ado, let's start. While the heroes fought at the outskirts of the Relic War Shield, Ip and Fairy Lee were inside of it. Lee was already corrupted by the darkness of the Relic. At that moment, Lee offers Ip a new Ward Legacy's heart, but it emanates a dark and evil aura. Tempted by this new dark power, Ip showed her astonishment and her concern, but her desire to help her peers in distress forced her to accept this new dark energy. By accepting this new power, Ip and the Fairy Lee merged into one, and from now on they will be known as Nightmare Corruptor Ip Lee. Without measuring the consequences, Ip fell into the temptation of power and the trap of Fairy Lee that now completely dominates her body, showing her true dark intentions to destroy everything. Ip Lee goes to the battlefield where the War Chalice heroes are fighting against the Mech Knights. Without distinguishing between friends or enemies, Ip Lee unleashes her power against everyone, defeating the Mech Knights and injuring her allies by taking away from them the powers granted by the Relic War Chalice. Ip Lee manages to get the Rainbow Gems of the Mech Knights, except for one. When Aurum receives Ip Lee's attack, he falls to an abyss, but something unexpected happens. The last surviving Mech Knight saves him by sacrificing himself, giving his gem and his powers to Aurum to give him a chance to stop the evil Ip Lee. Now, the hero has increased his powers and will be known as Mech Knight Abram. Meanwhile, Ip Lee, with the power of the other 6 gems, corrupts the fallen Mech Knights and transforms them into the 6 incarnations of destruction, the Nightmares, whom are now under her control. They inherit the power of the Rainbow Gems and wear some parts of the Mech Knight's armor. Ip Lee also awakens the Relic Ward Legacy, Wardlands, which was found in the ocean, and she makes her way toward it. Without losing any time, the heroes go to find Ip Lee to free her of the dark power, but they get intercepted by the Nightmares. Ningirsu offers to fight alone against the Nightmares and asks Abram to go save his sister. Even though Ningirsu can no longer have the power of the Relic Ward Chalice, he fears nothing, and he is determined to win and reunite with his sister. Abram decides to go along with Guard Dragon to stop Ip Lee. He finds Ip Lee on the outskirts of the Relic, but he is not willing to hurt his childhood friend. He tries to convince her to come to her senses, but it's effortless. He finally ends up getting defeated by her. Ip Lee grabs a sword from Abram to give him the final blow. But at that moment, Abram's little dragon appears, showing his hidden power, which awakens the spirit of Ip, which was imprisoned inside Ip Lee. Ip's spirit decides to end her own life in order to prevent the darkness that now dominates her body from hurting her friends. Abram and his little dragon try to stop her, but it's too late. Finally, Ningirsu shows up, only to see his sister die before his eyes. Abram begs Ip not to leave them. The future of the heroes is clear. Can a miracle happen?
To be continued. If you like the story, please make sure to subscribe, comment, share it and like it. Stay tuned. Until the next video, this has been your host, Team Seto.